talking about today. On the day of independence, he was flanking Kwame Nkrumah in that celebrative pose. When Nkrumah declared the independence of Ghana is meaningless unless it is linked up with the total liberation of the whole of Africa, everybody clapped. And the interesting thing is that you see this man there, when Nkrumah asked everybody to take off their hats so that they would listen to the national anthem, he was so much in a celebrative mood. He didn't hear Kwame Nkrumah say, take off your hat. He was the only one who was still wearing his hat. Until somebody told him that, hey, you are asked to take off your hat. In fact, he turned around and saw that everybody had taken off their hats, and then he also took off his hat. Today, we are looking at Archie Kesley Hefford. This is the class.
Yabo!
And in this class, we unearth everything, man. This is the lion story. They say until the lion learns to tell his own story, the tale of the hunt would always glorify the hunter. Today, my brother, my sister, we're talking about Archie Kesley Hefford. He was born in 1898, 11 years the senior of Kwame Nkrumah. In fact, 11 years, or better still, 10 and a half years, the senior of Kwame Nkrumah. My brother, my sister, he was born in Axim, in the Gold Coast. Oh my God. And look at what happened to him, my brother, my sister. Archie Kesley Hefford was born in Axim, in Gold Coast. His mother was called Beatrice Madeline. Beatrice Pinnock. Oh my God. And of course, she was a respected woman in the area. Very hardworking woman, self-made independent woman. And our hero's father was also a respected Pan-Africanist, and he went by the name Joseph Ephraim Kesley Hefford. Yes, we're talking about Joseph Ephraim Kesley Hefford. Now we're going to find time and talk about this man. Maybe we'll talk about him on Monday. Yes, he's a very interesting personality, and his life is going to blow you away. One of the early educated bourgeoisies, my brother, my sister, of the Gold Coast. And he had a lot of experience in the struggle to free people from the chains of slavery and colonialism. But today we're not talking about him. We are talking about his son, Archibald Kesley Hefford. In this class, we'll simply call him Archie. Archie Kesley Hefford. At a very young age, our hero for today, Archie, was educated at the Mfansipim School in Cape Coast. And when he finished that, with flying colors, I need to add that, he went all the way to Britain to be educated at Dulwich College. My brother, my sister, now it is a private day and boarding school for boys in Dulwich in London, England. Now it is a public school. At that time, it was a private school, and that was where he attended. When he finished Dulwich College, he decided to go all the way to study at Clare College at the University of Cambridge, receiving a Master of Arts degree in Law and Economics. Oh my God! So after returning home to the Gold Coast, he practiced as a lawyer from 1921. And in 1921, when he was a full-fledged lawyer, Kwame Nkrumah was only 12 years old. They were some of the earliest lawyers in this country. My brother, my sister, and he was astute. He used his law firm to support a lot of black people who did not even have any money to fight for their rights. His law firm was so formidable that so many people went there to seek help. Today, we're talking about Archibald Kesley Hefford. Now he rose to becoming a member of the Sekendi Town Council in 1926, 5 years after he returned from England. And he was made the first district magistrate in 1936. My brother, my sister. He rose to the senior district magistrate by 1948. Oh my God, he took time to grow. Even though it looked longer, He did not care. He would climb on the ladder. Yes, he would go through the meal. Oh my God. Mm-mm-mm. So from 1948, he decided to go back into private legal practice. And that was where he found himself in 1948. I'm going to be telling you something interesting soon. Brace up yourself for this beautiful news. My brother, my sister, he saw that he had to join politics because Kwame Nkrumah by 1948 was already in Ghana. Remember that Kwame Nkrumah arrived in the Gold Coast at that time, of course, called the Gold Coast, in 1947 on the invitation of the UGCC. And their main financier was the man, oh my God, George Alfred Grant, a.k.a. Pa Grant. My brother, my sister, who himself was born in 1798. Did I say 1798? 1896, my brother, my sister. Pa Grant, interesting personality, my brother, my sister. And today, we are talking about Archibald Kesley Hayford. Now, when Nkrumah arrived, it was at a point that our hero had also been promoted to the highest point of his career. But with Nkrumah in the country, he decided that he would leave and then join hands with Kwame Nkrumah to fight for independence. Remember, in 1948 was when Kwame Nkrumah broke away from the UGCC after that tussle. And he brought so much shine, so much crinkum crankum to the CPP and the politics of Ghana. Oh my God, at that time called the Gold Coast. Interesting things.
Yabo!
Hey! So when he joined Kwame Nkrumah in 1948, the CPP was born and he became the official lawyer of Kwame Nkrumah and all the other CPP people who needed a lawyer. At the same time, he opened up his chambers to other people in the CPP and even beyond who needed to be defended in court. So this was Kwame Nkrumah's very first lawyer. In fact, he became Kwame Nkrumah's very first lawyer and his only lawyer throughout his life. My brother, my sister, today we are talking about the man 11 years older than Kwame Nkrumah. And when Kwame Nkrumah died in 1972, he lived 5 more years ahead of Kwame Nkrumah and died in the same year as Kwame Nkrumah's mother, Nyaneba. Now, when you study history, some of these days come to you naturally. When you are talking about one man, 10 other people come in depending on the bad days and all that, they naturally come to you, students. So do not be surprised that we are mentioning all these dates just like that. Now listen, one thing about studying history, don't you ever try to memorize dates. Just read and let it flow in your spirit. Position the timelines at the appropriate places. Was it in the first century, second century, third century? That kind of thing would help you. And the dates will come in naturally. Some people tell us they don't want to study history because of the dates. It's very difficult for them to memorize dates. No, you don't need to memorize dates. Like a friend of mine who used to memorize a lot of sentences in novels. When you do that, you waste your time. Let it flow naturally. The human brain is a very sharp, 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 wonderful thing. It will naturally grasp it. Oh, gosh. Archibald Kesley Hayford joined Kwame Nkrumah in 1948. He became Kwame Nkrumah's lawyer, representing him wherever he went. And when Kwame Nkrumah finally got us independence on the Independence Day, he was standing there, as you can see him on the far left, his hands raised, holding his white handkerchief, and then declaring the independence of this country. This is the true Big Six. The other Big Six you saw is the fake Big Six. This is the real Big Six. Kwame Nkrumah standing there, my brother, my sister, with some other wonderful members of our country. Oh, my brother, my sister, they declared the independence of this country. Is Ghana truly independent? My brother, my sister, we may have to wake up Kwame Nkrumah from his slumber and ask him if Ghana is truly independent as he proclaimed on the 6th of March in 1957. Hear me now. K. Kesley Hereford was with Kwame Nkrumah all through. When independence was proclaimed, oh my God, see the interesting thing that happened. Oh, Kwame Nkrumah immediately made him a minister of state. Now, from the defense council for Kwame Nkrumah and other CPP leaders, he became a lawyer for the Veranda Boys as well. Do you all remember the Veranda Boys? They were the people who were supporting Kwame Nkrumah from the ghettos. We don't want to say ghettos, so we'll say from the grassroots. Oh my God. So before Shatta Movement, there was Veranda Boys. Yes, before Beam Nation, there was Veranda Boys. Before the Kuchoko Soldiers, there was Veranda Boys. My brother, my sister, in Kwame Nkrumah's first government, Kesley Hereford was appointed Minister of Agriculture. And he did very, very well. The Minister of Agriculture and Natural Resources, this was in 1951, even before independence. In Kwame Nkrumah's first government, remember, he was the Prime Minister. Later, he became the Minister of Communications. And in 1954, oh my God, even before independence, he became the Minister for the Interior. My brother, my sister, Kesley Hereford was honored by Ghana with the Grand Medal and was awarded the Queen's Coronation Medal from Britain. My brother, my sister, he was with Kwame Nkrumah. Such a very wonderful man, supported Kwame Nkrumah and the people of Ghana right from the beginning. He offered free services to the Veranda Boys and members of the CPP and even beyond. He was a man who was not scared to speak his mind. He was a legal think tank. He was a man so powerful. My brother, my sister, under Kwame Nkrumah, he risked his life a lot to see the people of Ghana rise another pedestal. Oh my God. But everything that has a beginning has an end. In the Gold Coast, he became the king of the courthouse. Everywhere somebody needed to be defended and he was black, you would most of the time see the face of Aki. Yes, Archibald Kesley Hereford. My brother, my sister. He was taken ill. And he died at the Rich Hospital, Accra, on the 20th day of August in 1977. He died of natural causes, my brother, my sister, in 1977 at the age of 78 or 79, as his date of birth was not so certain. Remember, we said he was born in 1898 circa. We don't know what month it was, but we know when he actually passed on. He died on the 20th day of August in 1977 at the Ridge Hospital right here in Accra. My brother, my sister, he left behind children such as Betty, Louise, and Desiree Kesley Hereford. Today we remember these wonderful people. Yes, Betty Kesley Hereford was a Ghanaian engineer herself. One of the children of the wonderful Kesley Hereford that we're talking about today. He was the first director of the Ghana Arts Council, a co-founder of the Ghana National Dance Ensemble, and a director of the Ghana Broadcasting Corporation. And that was the first child of Archibald Kesley Hereford. Today we remember you, Papa. Today we remember you. You were so true to Ghana. In fact, he held the post of Chancellor of the University of Cape Coast. And he was also a man who wrote a lot. My brother, my sister, today we remember you. One of his sons, Louise Kesley Hereford, was a chartered engineer who also served as the CEO of the Volta River Authority. Papa, today we remember you. He died at the age of 78 or 79. He was such an astute son of the land. Papa, uninyaminko. Papa, uninyaminko. Papa, yekai kai. Papa, yesi uninyaminko. Papa, uwe ya papa. Misi uwe ya. Papa, Miss Woo, yeah, yeah, oh. Uni yaminko papa. Papa minube ko wate. Papa famiko bi wate. Oh papa. Uni yaminko. Papa bye bye yo. Uni yaminko. Uni yaminko. Uni yaminko. In the burden of knowledge, I ask you, how will the story of Archibald Kesley Hayford, one of the proclaimers of the independence of this nation, one of the strongest supporters of Kwame Nkrumah, one of the strongest patriots of our land, how will this life story impact your own life in present times, in contemporary times? In the burden of knowledge, I ask you, now that you know what we do, be an any olea mini obafe, ye zunda kagane be zaka yine, ye anpa bango bukaya nung, fifia ye nyano kaina wobana enwe beden, lele anjima singa bekune, lele anjima singa beri. It's been the African History Club.
Tutu wavi, tutu wavi, apa mula homeo. Mama mula homeo, au na ima vinye, panumbo nungpo, mekepo, femi vie a, mwe